Assalamu alaikum friends. Welcome to this MATLAB tutorial. In this tutorial, I am going to teach you how to perform load flow analysis of IEEE 5 bus system using MATLAB programming. Consider the figure which shows the single line diagram of IEEE 5 bus system. It can be observed that bus 1 is considered as slack bus or swing bus. Another generator as well as load is connected at bus 2, whereas all the remaining buses are load buses. We have to determine the voltages at bus 2, 3, 4 and 5 using Newton-Raphson load flow method. Furthermore, we have to find the slack bus real and reactive power. The bus data and line data of the IEEE 5 bus system can be found on the internet. For your convenience, I have uploaded the IEEE 5 bus system data and its load flow solution in the form of PDF link in the description section. You can download it from there. Before going to start its MATLAB program, I want to highlight again that for the solution of load flow method in MATLAB, Hadi Sadat has already made the built-in functions. Therefore, for the convenience, you must have the MATLAB folders of Hadi Sadat book. On this topic, I have already made the video on how to save MATLAB folders of power system analysis book by Hadi Sadat in MATLAB using set path feature. I would strongly recommend to watch this video first for better understanding of this topic. It is because we will directly call the functions from the MATLAB folders of Hadi Sadat book. Let's start. At the first stage, we need to open the Hadi Sadat MATLAB folder in the current folder section. In the Hadi Sadat book, load flow analysis is covered in chapter 6. Therefore, I am going to open the example 6.9 MATLAB program to show the basic program format. Double click on this MATLAB program. It will be opened in M file. The program shows the basic format for writing the data in order to solve the load flow analysis. Copy the whole program. Click on this plus button to open a new M file and paste it here. Now save it by clicking on this button. Save it with any name of your choice and save it in the MATLAB folder of Hadi Sadat in order to avoid any error. You can see I have saved this M file in the Hadi Sadat MATLAB folder. It is because our program will call the admittance matrix and other MATLAB functions which are available here. If you add M file in any other folder, then MATLAB may give error due to the unavailability of those MATLAB function programs. Now look at the MATLAB program. You can see it shows here that this example is based on IEEE 30 bus system. As we want to do it for IEEE 5 bus system, therefore write here 5 and delete this sentence. Now look at the format of the MATLAB program. It may be noted that to perform the power flow analysis in MATLAB, four variables are defined, namely base MVA, power mismatch accuracy, acceleration factor, and maximum number of iterations. The values for these variables are set by default. However, you can change these values depending upon the need of the problem. Now we are going to put the values from IEEE data. At the first stage, we have to put the bus data. Just look at the format for the bus data. In the bus data, column 1 represents the bus number. Column 2 contains the bus code. Column 3 and 4 shows the voltage magnitude in per unit and phase angles in degrees. Column 5 and 6 shows the load in megawatt and MVAR. Column 7 through 10 are megawatt and MVAR, minimum MVAR and maximum MVAR of generation in that order. The last column is the injected MVAR of shunt capacitors, if any. Let's start to insert the data. For this purpose, just look at the IEEE 5 bus single line diagram. It may be noted that bus 1 is considered a slack bus having the voltage of 1.06 per unit with phase angle of 0 degree. Furthermore, the bus code for slack bus is also set to 1 by Hadi Sadat as shown here for the MATLAB program. Therefore, put the values of the bus 1 as shown here in order to represent the bus data of the slack bus. Make all other entries to 0 whose data is not given. Similarly, look at the figure again. Now we have to put the data for bus 2. We know that bus 2 in this example consists of a generator as well as load. Therefore, in this case, we will consider this bus as PQ bus or load bus. The bus code for the load bus is set to 0 as shown here for the MATLAB program. Therefore, put the values of the bus 2 as shown here in order to represent the data of the bus 2. Make all other entries to 0 whose data is not given. Similarly, look at the figure again. Now we have to put the data for bus 3. We know that bus 3 in this example is a load bus. The bus 3 has following parameters. Therefore, put the values of the bus 3 as shown here in order to represent the data of the bus 3. Make all other entries to 0 whose data is not given. Similarly, look at the figure again. Now we have to put the data for bus 4. We know that bus 4 in this example is again a load bus having following parameters. Therefore, put the values of the bus 4 as shown here in order to represent the data of the bus 4. Make all other entries to 0 whose data is not given. Similarly, look at the figure again. Now we have to put the data for bus 5. We know that bus 5 in this example is again a load bus having following parameters. Therefore, put the values of the bus 5 as shown here in order to represent the data of the bus 5. Make all other entries to 0 whose data is not given. It may be noted that IEEE system consists of 5 buses. Therefore, just keep these 5 lines of the program. Remove all other data which is not required in our case. At this stage, we have successfully inserted the bus data of the IEEE 5 bus system. Now we need to insert the line data of the IEEE 5 bus system. In the line data, we need the resistance, reactance and line charging susceptance of the transmission lines. For this purpose, just look at the figure again. The transmission line from bus 1 to bus 2 has the resistance of 0.02, reactance of 0.06 and susceptance of 0.03 respectively. Therefore, put the values from line 1 to 2 as shown here. The last column is for the transformer tape setting for lines. If line has any tape setting, then we have to put that value, otherwise 1 must be entered in this column. Therefore, write 1 here. Similarly, look at the figure again. The transmission line from bus 1 to bus 3 has the resistance of 0.08, reactance of 0.24 and susceptance of 0.025 respectively. Therefore, put the values from line 1 to 3 as shown here. Similarly, look at the figure again. The transmission line from bus 2 to bus 3 and bus 2 to bus 4 has the resistance of 0.06, reactance of 0.18 and susceptance of 0.02 respectively. Therefore, put the values from line 2 to 3 as well as from 2 to 4 as shown here. Similarly, look at the figure again. The transmission line from bus 2 to bus 5 has the resistance of 0.04, reactance of 0.12 and susceptance of 0.015 respectively. Therefore, put the values from line 2 to 5 as shown here. Similarly, look at the figure again. The transmission line from bus 3 to bus 4 has the resistance of 0.01, reactance of 0.03 and susceptance of 0.01 respectively. Therefore, put the values from line 3 to 4 as shown here. Similarly, look at the figure again. The transmission line from bus 4 to bus 5 has the resistance of 0.08, reactance of 0.24 and susceptance of 0.025 respectively. Therefore, put the values from line 4 to 5 as shown here. Now remove this remaining data in order to complete the line data for IEEE 5 bus system. Look at the remaining lines of the MATLAB program. It shows LFY bus, which is a MATLAB function to determine the bus admittance matrix for load flow analysis. For the successful operation, we must have the MATLAB program of these functions. Let me show you here that this MATLAB function is available here. Just click on LFY bus program. You can see it shows the MATLAB program to determine the bus admittance matrix for load flow analysis. Another function used is LFGAUS, as we are going to perform load flow analysis using Newton-Raphson method. Therefore, write here LFNewton and here Newton-Raphson method. This is also MATLAB built-in function developed by Hadi Sadat in his book. This function will directly perform the load flow analysis using the Newton-Raphson method. Let me show you here that this LFNewton MATLAB function is available here. Just double click on it to see its program. Now come to our MATLAB program again. We have another MATLAB function named BusOut. This function is used to show the power flow solution on the screen. Let me show you this function in our system. You can see BusOut MATLAB program is already saved here. Just double click on it to see its program. Now come to our MATLAB program again. We have another MATLAB function named line flow. This function is used to show the line flow and losses in the system. Let me show you this function in our system. You can see line flow MATLAB program is already saved here. Just double click on it to see its program. Now come to our MATLAB program again. Friends, at this stage we have successfully completed the MATLAB program for load flow analysis of IEEE 5 bus system. Now let's run the program by clicking on this button. It can be noticed that MATLAB gives error, namely LFY bus undefined function or variable. It means that MATLAB is not recognizing the LFY bus function. This may occur due to many reasons. One way to solve this error is that make the Hadi Sadat folder your current folder. You can see at this time this folder is not the current folder. Due to this, all these MATLAB functions are looking blurred. Therefore, just double click on this folder 1 to make it your current folder. When you will do it, all these MATLAB programs will be clearly visible, indicating that now this folder is working as the current folder. Now let's run the program by clicking on this button. You can see MATLAB has solved the load flow analysis of IEEE 5 bus system using Newton-Raphson method. Now compare the slack bus real power, reactive power, voltages and angles of bus 2, 3, 4 and 5 results with the IEEE 5 bus system load flow solution. You can see all the answers are almost correct. Friends, for your convenience, I have shared this M file load flow analysis program of IEEE 5 bus system in the form of link in the description section of this video. You can download it from there. Friends, in this video tutorial, I have discussed how to perform the load flow analysis of IEEE 5 bus system using Newton-Raphson method in MATLAB. By using the same strategy, the load flow analysis of any power system from small to large size can be carried out. That's all for today's tutorial. If you like it, then don't forget to like my video, subscribe my channel and share this with all your friends so that they may also get benefit from this video. Thank you very much.